And you have to realize, if you come as far as we did, that's the results of 1,000 small steps. You don't sit there, have a glass of wine, and say, in 2012, we will reach this. This is daily work, and you're going like this. It's not very straight, because it's undiscovered country.
On any given day, at any given time, we be the first eyes in the world to see something new, you know, every day has that promise. And of course it doesn't happen every day, but it's when you see that first glimpse of something that it makes everything else really worthwhile. We were working with developing prodrugs, in other words, drugs that can be cleaved by certain enzymes in a tumor to be active. And so we wondered, well, if we can use this approach, maybe we could also use this basic idea for detecting enzyme activity in the serum.
We had to design a nanoparticle of about 20 nanometers, which has the ability to quench the light of an organic sensitizer. That's a dye, and this dye shines. If you put some light on, it shows fluorescence, but only if it's free of the nanoparticles. So if both are together, then the dye doesn't shine, and there is a linker. And this linker can be chopped by an enzyme, and that's how we detect our cancer enzymes. So in the absence of an enzyme, nanoparticle and dye are together. In the presence of an enzyme, they become loose, and then the dye shows fluorescence. So the number of photons we get out, or just how much light we get out, is indicative of how active this enzyme is in blood serum. And then we do these tests for 15 enzymes in parallel and get something which we call a protease signature, just showing how much of each enzyme is there. But the working hypothesis is that it works on every solid tumor. A solid tumor is a tumor somewhere in your body, not like leukemia, for instance. So a solid tumor has problems. It has to connect to the blood supply. It has to grow against the tissue. And then, of course, it has to colonize the whole body. And so these enzymes are helping the tumor doing just that.
We're actually testing this on human serum samples now. And we're collaborating with the University of Kansas Cancer Center to test some other kinds of cancer.
And we do work with an expert in statistics, that's Dr. Gary Gadbury, who is analyzing the data that we have, and we need this independent statistical analysis to be sure that our results are really meaningful. And actually, he found that we have a 95% probability to really see early breast cancer and early lung cancer in human patients. This project is one part of the bigger endeavor that we have. So cancer detection in blood samples is very vital, because early detection will save a lot of lives. We estimate that we can save approximately 50% of lives with the technology that is available right now by recognizing cancer earlier. The same technology can be applied to find tumors in your body and to mark tumor boundaries. Surgeons have always the problem that they have to excise the right tumor. You don't want to excise too much, and you don't want to excise too little. This technology helps to see the exact boundary between cancers and healthy tissue.
I have postdocs in my lab who are also involved. And actually, a couple of very good postdocs came from Dr. Bossmann's lab, so they have a very excellent background in chemistry.
What's important is to see that if you want to beat cancer, we have to be functional. And you cannot do this without the expert input from the biology, from the medicinal side. And these hurdles at Kansas State are usually very low, and I appreciate that I can collaborate with colleagues. But of course, and Dr. Troyer's in my case, that's a special case, because it works so well. And so much fun to do.